Rock Metal Nation, what is up? This is John from the Rock Metal Podcast with a special episode for you, Rock Metal Nation. Arch Enemy is currently on tour with Amon Amarth at the Gates and Grand Magus on the Berserker World Tour 2019. Amon Amarth is headlining, and they have Arch Enemy at the Gates and Grand Magus supporting. The tour runs in North America from September 26th to October 26th. And on September 30th, I was able to sit down with Sharlee backstage at the Edmonton Convention Center to chat about the tour, chat about the show, chat about the band's most recent releases. So, Rock Metal Nation, let's go ahead and jump right into this interview with Arch Enemy with Sharlee D'Angelo.
Let's go!
Rock Metal Nation, what is up? This is John from the Rock Metal Podcast coming to you. What is this, like a backstage area, yeah?
It is, yes.
Sweet. All right, backstage area. I now get to jam my phone in people's faces instead of talking to them on Skype, which is fantastic. And
well, yeah, makes for a nice change, doesn't it?
Sure does. Sweet. So we're here at the Berserker World Tour 2019 with Amon Amarth, Arch Enemy, at the Gates, Grand Magus, North America, September 26th to October 26th. I'm being joined by Sharlee of Arch Enemy right now.
Yeah.
So welcome.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely, yeah. 4 days into the tour, how's it going?
Very good, actually. I mean, it's nice. Everything's starting to, you know, with any sort of like four band package, and especially with Amon Amarth having like quite a large stage production themselves. Like, so there's a lot of stuff, like a lot of technical stuff that needs to get in order the first few days. So it takes a few days, but now I think it's like everybody sort of like know where to go and how to do it, and so it's, you know, it's starting to run very, very smoothly. But the shows have been great. All, you know, the first, well, they've been fantastic. It's great to be on this because I know everybody in all the bands from before anyway. So it's just like a whole get together with a whole bunch of buddies.
Sweet. Now, mentioned one of the highlights that you mentioned was that basically it's a bunch of friends getting together. I mean, outside of that, what has been the best part so far?
On the tour, you mean?
Yeah.
The shows, always. Yeah. I mean, it's been great, and especially for us, we get to play to, you know, play to other people, expose ourselves to people we haven't exposed ourselves to before.
Yeah.
It's good. I mean, you can see sort of like early in the show, I mean, we have definitely have our sort of like some of our core fans here, but then you can see there are people that are there that just like, no, what's this? Let's check it out.
Yeah.
And then at the end of the night, it's like, you know, all arms raised and all horns up, which is great, you know, because that means that we probably impressed somebody at least and gained some new fans, which is, you know, the point of sort of like going out and doing one of these things, you know,
Nick, something that you mentioned was, you know, we've got this four band package, and I was just curious what inspired making this four Swedish onslaught through North America.
I think you have to ask Amon Amarth about that, actually. That was, I don't know if that was like their initial idea to have like all Swedish bands, but no, we got approached like it was a long time ago now, and you know, we thought it would be, you know, golden opportunity to go back to the States again, and then at the Gates again, and then Grand Magus as well, which is this is I think their first U.S. tour, so
yeah.
So it's great, you know, but it's good, you know, everybody speaks Swedish.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Fantastic. Now, some of the releases on this tour are going to be Will to Power and Covered in Blood. And obviously, you probably have answered a lot of questions about Will to Power by this point.
That's fine.
But, you know, the first album with the current lineup, right?
That's right. Yep, yep.
Now, I guess my big honking question is, how did that go? How has it been received?
It's been fantastic. I mean, we've definitely taken another step, you know, in the right direction. I think you can just see it, like from the last album, we put in a lot of groundwork on the last album, you know, toured like crazy. And then once that whole touring cycle ended and we did Wheel to Power, I mean, it seemed like everybody we had done, you know, we have been noticed at least, you know, because like then after, like when you start to like plan the next tour, like everybody seemed to be on board and behind us. So it's like that's a good thing. So, and we felt that we have really like a super, super strong album. So it's good to like put it out there, and it's been extremely well received. I mean, if you look at in terms of, well, you can see today, I mean, it's more sort of like, you know, how many YouTube clicks does something have? And, you know, and our most popular video on YouTube is the second single from Will to Power, like by far.
It's When the Eagle.
When the Eagle Flies Alone, which is now past 50 million.
Wow.
Yeah. Which is just like, okay. And you can definitely tell, like, that we have, I mean, there's been, for every new album we make, there seems to be a new generation of fans coming out as well. So now it's like the best response is always the stuff from the last two albums, which is just like, for a band that's been around as long as we have, I mean, like over 20 years, it's usually the other way around. It's like, oh, it's, you know, it's that album, you know, that one, the classic album from 16, 17 years ago. It's that one. But for us, it's like, you know, we try to play like older stuff. And a lot of our newer fans, they just like look bewildered. Like, they, oh, okay, cool. Is this a new song? So we try to, but I mean, it's, it is predominantly like new stuff that we do, because it just seems to have, seems to get the best response. But then again, like when we're out headlining, when we have, you know, an hour 45 to play, then we can, you know, mix it up as much as we want. So
right. Now, with regard to the show tonight, then, are you guys going to be mixing it up or just playing mostly new stuff?
There are stuff from stuff as far back as 2000. So yeah.
Okay.
So yeah, I mean, it's a little bit of, but it's predominantly from the last two albums and then a few other ones. You know.
Okay. Kind of going back to, you know, when the Eagle is, did you guys know that that was going to explode the way that it did? Like,
no. But we just felt sort of like we were thinking about, okay, we're going to do two singles, so we need to do two videos. So that's when you take like the first decision. Okay, so these will have to be the two first. And I think the opening track, The World Is Yours, is like that. Felt okay, but this is just classic Arch Enemy. Seems to be like the best first single. But then like for the second one, I think almost like immediately everybody just agreed, I mean, let's do Eagle, because there's just something about it. And we haven't really had a song that's like in that type of tempo and with that kind of groove, that's just very sort of like extremely straightforward. So it was sort of like, yeah, it's like a new thing for us. So we have also like just thought it felt fresh. I mean, it's a very simple melody in it as well. Mm-hmm. It's just like there's not really... That's, you know, that's almost like in, and when it comes to like in the middle of the set, it's almost like you get a break, because it's fairly easy to play as well, which is great. So you can basically just put all your feel behind it. You don't have to concentrate on your actual sort of like playing on it. It's great.
Well, congratulations.
Yeah.
And then with Covered in Blood, I guess my question is, why a cover album, and what went into choosing the covers?
Well, the thing is, it's not an album that we went in and did. It's just a collection of covers that we've done through over 22 years now. Because we've usually done them for, Japanese bonus tracks and, you know, single B-sides and things. We do one or two of those, whatever we do an album. And we just like, sort of like, when all the real work is done, you could just like have a little bit of fun. Okay, well, we have to... Do we have 2 days left? Yeah, we do. Let's just like smack something together, and we do.
Right.
Which is, you know, and it's kind of fun, and you can sort of show people your influences, and maybe influence them to go back and discover some of the stuff that we come from. So, you know, people can see where we come from, basically.
Right.
But so when we did the vinyl box set, we just put together a collection of it's basically just I think it is all the covers we've ever done, and just
like
put
if we're on CDs, I think it's like two CDs out.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So we just put them together, and that would be like a nice addition to that. And then once the box set was sold out, well, people asking about it, because it's like, well, I have all the other ones, but that one we can't get it now because the box set is sold out. So we had a talk with the label, and they agreed to put it out as a single release as well. So we, you know,
yeah.
Just so people can get a hold of it.
The luxurious problem of running out of things to sell.
Yeah. Well, we don't seem to be running out of things to sell at all.
Fantastic. Now, going back to the show tonight, a big question I know that I have, and for, you know, the audience listening in, is, are we going to hear any new material tonight?
No. This is not going to be anything new. And especially, I mean, we very rarely do that. But especially tonight when we have a very limited set. I mean, we only have 45 minutes to play with, and we do try to do our best just to impress people with that, what we got. And so, no, so that's not really the time to go out and premiere new stuff.
Right. So then I guess the big question is, how does Arch Enemy, with over 20 years of experience, impress people in 45 minutes?
Yeah. Well, see, that's one of the sort of like luxury problems as well. We have so many songs, and as you go along, you get so many of these, like, you know, must play songs that people will scream after. It's like, but that's hard. So you really need to, like, you know, learn to kill your darlings, because there's no way. I mean, even when we have a 90-minute set, sometimes, or like, say, festival set like 75, it'd be like, I'm like, wow, that's hard. Well, how about that one? What about that one? No, no. And then somebody else, no, we want to play this one. I'm like, okay, well, is yeah. So we basically, you just think about, like, so you put together a well-balanced set, and you think about where you are. I mean, now we know we'll be opening up for Amon Amarth, and so we basically, we don't have to think about, like, oh, we got to show our softer side or anything, something like that, you know, because that's the good thing about, because these people are metal fans from the beginning. We don't have to do anything about that, but yeah, so we just try to, you know, just a chain of our best and easier to understand songs.
Yeah, something you mentioned was the softer side. I noticed that Alyssa's doing some clean vocals on the new album, a small amount anyway, which was incredible. I actually enjoyed that a lot. Is that a direction you guys are going to be headed going forward, or?
Well, we haven't really thought in terms of that. I mean, it was just with that song, it was written, and we thought, it'd be weird for that to, can't really sort of like growl on that, because it's more of a ballad. And we thought, well, if we could have clean vocals on it, then it might be a thing. And Alyssa was up for it, and, you know, we came up with the melody and everything, and it worked out fine. And then, so, okay, well, great. So it's more like the song called for clean vocals. It's not that we think, oh, we got to have clean vocals. I mean, it's whatever the song takes, you know. So there might be some of the new one, or there might not. We still don't know.
Cool. Now, for people who, for whatever reason, can't make it out to the tour in North America, mm-hmm. is there going to be... like any tour diaries or anything available online on socials or as the tour goes on?
Maybe we do tons of things like every day, like just like little snippets. If you're on Instagram, if you're on Facebook, if you're whatever. I mean, there's always little posts like every day. We haven't really like gone to do real sort of like little like tour diary things, but there are snippets of live things. We put up songs if we have good footage from something, and it's that. I mean, it happens every day, several times a day, so you just need to be there.
Okay, fantastic. Is there anything else about the tour that you wanted me to address that I didn't ask?
No. I think we covered most of it.
All right, fantastic. Well, thank you so much, Sharlee, for coming on to the show. It's kind of weird to welcome you to my show, but I'm at your show.
Yes, exactly.
But thanks for coming on and for sharing.
Sure. Yeah. Thank you very much.
All right, Rock Metal Nation. Hope you thoroughly enjoyed and got a lot out of the interview with Sharlee from Arch Enemy. Well, they're currently on tour supporting Amon Amarth and also playing with At the Gates and Grand Magus on the Berserker World Tour 2019. Again, those dates in North America are September 26th to October 26th. Go ahead and look up Arch Enemy on their Facebook page. You can go ahead and get those links on today's show notes at www.therockmetalpodcast.ca. You go ahead and catch up with the tour as it comes through your city. And if it already has come through your city, then awesome, man. I hope you had a great time at the show as they blew your face off and left your soul. In the meantime, Rock Metal Nation, I really hope you enjoyed the interview. If you're listening on a platform that allows some comments, let me know what you thought of the interview so I know... You know, hey, should I do more interviews just like these? And in the meantime, Rock Metal Nation, well, rock on, baby.